Hello everyone, I'm Brandon with Lenovo, and I'm here with the ThinkCenter M93P Tiny Desktop. Today we're going to be replacing the power switch board. The process will take about 10 minutes, and it should be easy enough for anyone to do. The only tool required will be a Phillips screwdriver. Before we continue, we need to make sure that we're protected against electrostatic discharge or ESD. Make sure to shut down your computer and disconnect all cables and accessories from the system. For more information, watch our Understanding Electrostatic Discharge video by clicking the link in the description. And now that we're ready, let's get started. To remove the computer cover, we're going to remove a single retaining screw in the rear of the computer. Then you slide the front cover forward and lift it from the system. To disconnect the storage drive cable, you just pull it from the back of the storage drive and then disconnect the SATA cable from the system board. Then disconnect the power cable from the system board. And I'm going to use a non-metallic pry tool to disconnect the front antenna cable, but your fingers will work just as well. Now we're going to remove two retaining screws. The second one. To remove the drive assembly, you're going to slide it away from the edge of the system and lift it off of the posts. To remove the power button board, first remove a single retaining screw. Lift the power button board forward and off of the tab on the chassis, and then disconnect the cable from the system board. So here I have my replacement power switch board. To replace the power button board, first plug the connector into the system board. Then align the power button board with the tab on the chassis and replace the single retaining screw. To replace the drive assembly, we're going to align the assembly with these two posts on the system board. So you align the post and then slide the assembly towards the edge of the system. We're going to replace two retaining screws. Screw one and screw two. Now I'm going to reconnect the front antenna cable. I'm using a non-metallic pry tool, but your fingers will work just as well for this. It just kind of snaps on like a button. To connect the storage drive cable, connect the power cable to the system board and the SATA cable to the system board. And then connect the cable to the back of the storage drive. So to replace the computer cover, you just kind of lay it down here on top of the system, and then you push it towards the rear of the system until it locks into place. And then you replace this single retaining screw in the rear of the system.